Welcome to another session of Learning Together. This time, let's talk about testing of grammar. The testing of grammar is one of the mainstays of language testing. While such tests test the ability to either recognize or produce correct grammar and usage, they do not test the ability to use the language to express meaning. However, it can be argued that the basic knowledge of grammar underlies the ability to use language to express meaning. And so, grammar tests have an important part to play in language programs. So these are the types of tests that you can use when testing grammar. The first one, the very common multiple choice test. The most common way of testing grammatical knowledge is the multiple choice test. These tests have the advantage of being easy to grade, but hard to make, and being able to cover a lot of grammatical points quickly. The most common type of multiple choice grammatical item is one in which the test maker gives the testee a sentence with a blank and four or five choices of a word or phrase which completes the sentence correctly. For example, this one, because my mother was sick, I blanked to go home last week. So you have here the four choices. Some of the items would have letter E, none of the above. Okay, but commonly it has four choices. But to give slightly more context, this type of question sometimes makes use of short dialogue, which one person saying something and the other person is also responding. A way of testing short answers and responses is to give the testees an utterance and have them decide which of the four or five utterances is an appropriate response. This can be either a test of comprehension or a test of grammar. For example, the second example here. Okay, I think the tuition is much too high here. So you have to choose what is the best or the correct response to this particular sentence. Okay, this is the example. Another way to test grammatical knowledge using multiple choice items is to give the testees, meaning the one who will take the test, a sentence and ask them to choose which of the four or five alternatives has the same meaning. Just like the example here, the school should have expelled him. So you have to choose between the four items, which of the four has the same meaning with the previous or the statement above. Again, this is a test of reading comprehension as well as grammar. But in order to understand the meaning of the sentence, the reader does have to understand the grammar, of course. Okay? So, the technique here is that the test maker must find a balance between giving enough context and giving too much. One way to give more context and make the language more natural is to give the items in the form of short reading passages rather than individual sentences to have to create this overall scenario. This gives the testees more context, and if the passage is chosen carefully, is also much more interesting than reading individually uncontextualized sentences. Okay, however, it may be more difficult to test a range of grammatical points since the grammatical points are restricted by the content of the passage. Next type of examination to test grammar is the error correction. So an error correction items are also useful for testing grammar. An error correction is one in which the testee is given a sentence with an error. Four words or phrases in the sentence marked with letters, and the testee needs to decide which of the words or the phrases that has been underlined has the error. For example here, most of the students, that's letter A, believe that they should be getting better grades than they are. Okay, and then they have to choose which of the following underlined phrases, words and phrases contain the error. Okay, The teacher may also mix in some sentences that have no errors, and students are required to indicate that there is no error. Okay? In addition, the students must be required to correct the errors if there are. Next, attempts to test knowledge of word or sentence order. The traditional way is to present the testee with four alternative word orders, just like the first example here. Okay? Another possibility is to give the testees the four words and ask them to put the words in order, just like example number two. And then they have to arrange it by letters, which of the four should come first. Okay? This can also be done in a way that actually requires the writer to do some writing. For example, here, example number three. So I wonder how she knows, and then blank, and then the choices here below, and then you have to decide which of the four should be the first, the second, and the third, and the last. Okay? So understanding of the appropriate sentence order can also be tested in a similar way by giving the testees several sentences and asking them to put them in order. Okay? This type of test tests knowledge of references, cohesive devices, and etc. The next one here is completion items. Okay? Completion items are items in which the testees are asked to fill in the blanks in the sentences. Okay, just like the example here, give the book to blank woman in the blue dress. So as the taker, you have to decide, as the testee, you have to decide which word is appropriate to fill in that particular blank. Okay, for the purpose of a grammar test, the words which fit in the blanks should be function words. When we say function words, these are the articles and then the prepositions. On the other hand, completion items intended to test reading ability or vocabulary knowledge. In contrast, you have to use content words. The advantage of completion items is that they test production, not just recognition. And the disadvantage, on the other hand, is that they need to be marked by hand, and there will be some cases where the marker needs to make judgments about whether a response is correct. Okay, it is time-consuming. Another type of grammar item makes use of transformations. In this type of item, testees are given a sentence and the first few words. Testees are given a sentence and the first few words of another sentence to change the original sentence without changing the meaning. For example here, this is how you do transformation item. This type of test is difficult to grade because the teacher has to be aware of the variety of possible answers. Another problem is that it does not in any way test the testee's knowledge of when each of the possible transformations would be most appropriate. Another type of test to test grammatical knowledge is the word changing items. In here, the testees are given a sentence and a word which they need to fit into the sentence by changing the form of the word. This type of grammar item tests students' knowledge of different word forms and how they are used in the sentence. Next is a sentence combining exercises. Sentence combining exercises can play a part in testing grammar, as well as its more traditional use as a part of composition testing and training. For example, the testees might be instructed to combine the following sentences using a relative pronoun, just like the example here. While the testing of grammatical knowledge is limited, it does not necessarily indicate whether the testee can use the grammatical knowledge in a communicative situation. It is sometimes necessary and useful. When considering the testing of grammar, the teacher has to make decisions about such factors as ease of marking, the degree of control, and then the degree of realism. Of course, a realism of your sentences. Okay, that's all for testing of grammar.